One of the great venues to watch a game in any sport and one of the best home crowds in any sport, Soldier Field in Chicago. Today on to week 15 in the NFL, and we've got a good matchup in store as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Chicago Bears. Set for football now on a sunny afternoon in the second city. And off we go from Soldier Field. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. Start things off with a carry by Gibbs here. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case this year. You think he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch this late in the season, he needs that big closing game, that game that we're all going to reflect on and go, oh, my goodness, did he put up a number, let's say 200-plus?
First and 10, Richardson looks to throw it. Flush to his right. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. This offense, Charles, well, we've talked about how well they played all season, sitting now at 13-0 with a finish line for a perfect regular season. That's in sight. Some in the media this week were pointing back to the 07 Patriots. Of course, remember, they finished the regular season unbeaten, but they were tested multiple times in that final month plus.
Yeah, it was something like 4 of their last 6 wins were one possession games, and they played like a team that was trying to protect something instead of chasing something. And that's what happens when you have an undefeated record. So it behooves you as a team, get a couple blowouts in there so you get a chance to relax and breathe. But that's much easier said than done. I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
First and 10, it's Richardson. And his throw is going to be incomplete. These two teams had met at Ford Field earlier this season with the Lions winning that ball game. So they're looking for the series sweep here in Chicago. Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Laviska Shenault, the intended target. And that'll make it third down. You look at this Bears defense. They were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
In today's football, there aren't a lot of goals for defenses. But when you hold a team under 100 total yards of offense, yeah, that has to be a goal that was met. Big check mark for them in last week's game.
And Richardson yet again. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So they take the flag and the yardage that comes with it. Gibbs straight ahead. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line. This defense for the Bears, they were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
Today's NFL, when you talk about goals for defenses and you think that maybe you'd like to hold them under 14 points or so, we think our offense can usually get 17 to 20, so that's a reasonable goal. But when you hold a team under 100 yards of total offense, you're going to win 99 times out of 100. And the one game you lose, you'll know who to blame.
On second down. Here's a keeper by the QB.
He'll get two on the keeper, but it becomes now a third down.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving a running back a crease to run through. And that's a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down.
Richardson.
They send out the field goal unit here. And this a 39-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone.
And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10
at their own 12-yard line. On play action, they'll throw.
Look at the big man Lumber.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Nice play call, a little bit of play action right there. If you get those linebackers to freeze for just a split second, that's usually all the room you need in order to get it to your tight end.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
On the run, this is J.K. Dobbins. He'll get this to about the 38. The Bears had 6-7, a game under 500 on the year. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset, being in the right frame of mind. And the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain.
And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
They go play action with Richardson.
His throw incomplete.
Looking for Michael Mayer on the play,
but it's going to be second down.
You look at this Bears defense.
They played well against the pass, currently ranked 7th in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top 5.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On third down, here's Gibbs.
And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of first. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth.
Richardson looking to throw this. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
Now Richardson back to throw it. Setting up the screen. This is Gibbs.
And he'll get blown up behind the line as scrimmage, back at the six. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. On second down, here's Gibbs. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Jahmyr Gibbs, that's his 18th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead grows to 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown, so decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan, or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
On play action, Fields. There's Chris Olave. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit. So from the 36 now, first and 10. An option handoff here to Dobbins. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Ten nothing the score after one on EA Sports. Back in Chicago, ready for the second quarter. It's the Bears in possession as they've got it with a second and 10. Now it's Fields. He'll swing this out to Dobbins. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield, you're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay gain.
Throwing on third down, Fields. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Let's go now.
On first down, Richardson. That one's complete out to Michael Mayer. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Richardson to the air on first down. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Straight ahead with Gibbs here. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now throwing on third down there, but he can't
connect. And giving him that drop start. Oh, it's a nice job defensively to force that into third down.
And his kick is right there. It's good, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, they already had the early lead, and they get the interception, Charles, and now they add three more with the field goal.
Yeah, they're in control of how this game is playing out so far. You mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured bear on the field.
Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively. Obviously, two drives, two interceptions.
This is where you have to know your quarter.
Oh, Fields is intercepted for a third time. Picked by Tracy Walker. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
Richardson to throw off play action. That's caught. It's Sam Laporta.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game, but in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
And from the 34, here's second and four. Now it's Richardson. Going underneath, Gibbs has it.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 yards there and a Lion first down.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
First and 10. Here's Richardson with it.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Mecole Hardman, touchdown number 15 of the year, as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. Extra point right down the middle, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands. I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On second and 10, Fields.
And Shark calls it in. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 22 yards there, a first down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
And Shark goes in motion left.
On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line.
Fields changing the play.
play action fake. They'll look to throw. Tries the left side and finds Olave.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. That one complete. He finds Shark. Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. A gain of 2 brings up fourth down. Oh, they're changing this at the line. They snap it to Fields. That is caught. And he is going to have the Bears first down as he pushes forward for a couple on fourth and inches. And we've got movement. I think this is against the Bears here. Let's find out. A full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Fields throwing again. Olave over the middle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
On first down, Fields. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. DJ Chark, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bears get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, getting into the locker room. This is it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. And a lot of football, full half to be played. Dallas Flowers going to bring this out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Already enjoying a 2-score lead here late in the second quarter. Not a ton of time left. We'll see if they can work this at least into field goal range and try to get 3 to add on even more to their lead. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And with apologies to Dylan Thomas, apparently they're not going to go gently into the half. They're still out there firing haymakers. They took a chance on a deep ball there, but it winds up incomplete.
Catch is made by Hardman. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun, Richardson. Open man completes it to Claypool. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 17 more yards. They had 17 on the previous snap as well. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Time. Let's make some noise. First and 10, here's Gibbs. And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 35. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. In motion left, Claypool. First and 10, it's Richardson. Escaping the pressure right. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I did like his decision-making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing the throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down, and don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face, because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner, and usually he's able to use his body and catch the football, but a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. And they'll send the tight end in motion left. Out of the gun, they'll give to Gibbs. Touchdown, Detroit! Jahmyr Gibbs in the final seconds of the first half. And the Lions would extend their lead here just before halftime.
Yeah, they would have been happy with a first down, but this is even better. Once he's past the marker, it's cream cheese from there. And he bumps it to the outside, and it's just going to run away from defenders on his way toward the pylon.
Point after, right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to an even 20. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. That's complete to Mooney. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter.
A final shot before the break. Fields
eluding the pressure right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half. Now, this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Well, they look up at the scoreboard, facing that deficit. A three-score game, Charles, but look, there's plenty of time to go here. The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though, out of this drive, at least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no three-score drive on that play sheet for any of those coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive, but maybe cut into it a little bit, as you just suggested. Try and create a little bit of momentum, a little bit of a spark, and then maybe that'll carry over.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Our time to shine, fellas.
To throw his Fields. He'll swing this out to Dobbins. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. It's a pickup of 10 and a Bears first down. From the gun, here's Fields. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
Here's second and 10. Here's Fields. It's complete to Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Off play action, Fields. The throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. 5 yards, now it's third and five. That ground game contained again there, Charles, and that's really a big reason that they're trailing right now.
And give a lot of credit to that defensive front. That's exactly what they worked for all week, to try and take away the run game, make them one-dimensional. In the battle of game plans, theirs has been superior.
From the gun on third down, Fields. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down.
Okay, let's make some good calls, offense. Let's show them what we're made of, offense.
Out of the gun, Fields. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. So a big play there on fourth, and now first and 10 at the 30. Fields. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over
them. Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Dobbins. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bears are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. Santos now to add the PAT. He's got it, and the score's now 27-14. The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away.
But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
And you could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And this will wind up a Lions first down as he gets it up past the 35.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside, and so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Here's a throw dropped off to his fullback. Call it a gain of a yard, and that will bring up second down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Counterplay, here's Gibbs. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Another run for Gibbs here. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 113 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ballgame.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Hand off now to Gibbs. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From the 43, here's second and six. And they'll go to the air now with Richardson. They'll roll him out right. And he'll just get rid of it.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. From the gun, Gibbs will get it. And this won't do it. He needed six. He only got half of the ball. Too long for the field goal. Too short to punt that in-between range. And they'll go for it on fourth down. Richardson looking to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A defensive breakdown allows a pickup of 16 on fourth down. So after the fourth down conversion, now first and 10 inside the 25. Richardson off the play fake. That's Samaya, the tight end. Touchdown! Michael Mayer, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Lions are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter.
So the Lion offense staying on the field as they're going to try for two. They'll try and run it here. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
33, Bears 14.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25.
Bears take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Here's Fields. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
Now Fields going to move him around.
They can't stop us. Hold those chains. Keep them moving.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Fourth down, Fields has to have this one. That is caught, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. There he goes, left side. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They go play action with Richardson.
They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
On the give, here's Gibbs. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
19
on third down, here's Richardson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And in for the Lions, touchdown. Chase Claypool from 19 yards away.
And the Lions add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that will bump the lead up to 26. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
Yeah, absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
And they'll run the option on third and short yardage. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 52 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Fields on first down. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest gain we've seen on a scramble, but still, some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
Play action. It's Fields. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Multiple defenders getting home there for a loss of 11.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack, just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
Connecting here with Chark on the out route. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 27-yard line. That was no third and two. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway. On first down, it's Fields. He completes it to Olave. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another big game of that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Back to throw. Fields. Flush to his right. Throw right side. This is into the hands of the tight end, Tonyan. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
To the air again, Fields. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident throw right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're gonna have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
On fourth down, Fields. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And this 11-play drive is going to lead to nothing on the scoreboard. Drive starts with a run from Gibbs. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14.
60 Bison. 70 Ranger. 70 Ranger.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. Now he's loose again. Off to the races. Inside the 20. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And we talked so much about the turnover battle determining who wins and who loses. This game, no exception. They didn't turn the ball over at all.